Hello everyone, hope you all are doing great. If you are new on my channel, then kindly subscribe my channel and don't forget to like and share the video. In today's video, I am going to discuss with you about types of hepatitis. In the previous video, I have already explained the hepatitis and its causes. If you have not watched it yet, kindly go and watch it. I have mentioned the link in the description box. So let's start. Types of hepatitis, they are of 6 types, that is A, B, C, D, E and G. Firstly, we talk about hepatitis virus A. How it is transmitted? Consuming food or drink contaminated with the feces of someone with the infection. It is a waterborne disease. This hepatitis is commonly called infectious hepatitis. As it is a waterborne disease, it is contracted through contaminated water, food, sewage, and also transmitted by fecal-oral route. Symptoms include nausea, fatigue, dark urine, vomiting, fever, jaundice, and anorexia. People who get hepatitis A may feel sick for a few weeks to several months but usually recover completely. Hepatitis virus B and hepatitis virus C. I am going to explain B and C together because the mode of transmission and symptom of both the hepatitis is same. The mode of transmission of both the virus. For hepatitis virus, it is making contact with the body fluids of a person with the infection, usually from the women to the fetus at birth, but occasionally from using contaminated needles. For hepatitis virus C, it is making contact with blood containing the virus, spread through contaminated needles of IV drug users. It is a blood-borne disease. Hepatitis B is caused by virus hepatitis B and hepatitis C is caused by virus hepatitis C. These two types are more severe and prolonged in nature and leads to death also. It is transmitted by blood transfusion, improperly sterilized syringes, sexual contact, and saliva of an infected person. Symptoms include for hepatitis virus B is unease, fatigue, anorexia, and mild illness. For hepatitis virus C, it is 80% of people have no symptoms but others have unease, fatigue, and anorexia. One is hepatitis virus T. How it is transmitted? Same as hepatitis virus B, this hepatitis type is also known as Delta hepatitis. Hepatitis T only occurs in persons who are also infected by hepatitis B virus. If anyone have hepatitis B and at the same time he is also infected by hepatitis D, then it is known as co-infection. But when a person is suffering from hepatitis B and after some time he is infected with the hepatitis D, then it will be known as superinfection. Symptoms include unease, fatigue, anorexia, and mild illness. It can cause severe symptom and severe illness that can lead to lifelong liver damage and even death. One is hepatitis virus E. What is the mode of transmission of hepatitis virus E? It is usually through consuming undercooked meat or food or drink uncontaminated with the feces of someone with the infection, but occasionally from a pregnant woman to a fetus. It is a waterborne disease that occurs mostly due to a lack of proper sanitation facilities. The major cause of hepatitis virus E is improper hygiene and sanitation like defecation in open areas, unhealthy drinking water, consumption of raw foods, and many more. These include mild illness only. Next one is hepatitis virus G. How it is transmitted? Through blood containing the virus. And the symptoms include mild infection, but most people have no symptoms. And this is the crux of all the above slide which I taught earlier. Column is for the virus, this is for mode of transmission, this is for prevention, and this is for treatment. So first is hepatitis virus A. How it is transmitted? From contaminated food and water. How it will be prevented? By improved hygiene practices and vaccination. There is no available treatment for hepatitis virus A. Next one is hepatitis virus B. Its mode of transmission is contact with infected body fluid. Prevention, blood screening, improved hygiene and vaccination, treatment, nucleotide analogs, pegylated interferon. Next one is hepatitis virus C. How it spreads, intravenous drug use, not sterilized medical equipment. Prevention include blood screening, sterilized needles for drug infection, sanitary healthcare settings. Treatment include direct acting antiviral agents with or without pegylated interferon. Hepatitis virus D, how it spreads, is spread through contact with infected blood. Prevention include blood screening, sterile needles for drug infection, practice safe sex. Chronic hepatitis D can be treated with interferon. Next one is hepatitis virus spread. It is spread through blood-to-blood contact, unsafe sex, and during childbirth. Prevention include improved hygiene, avoid uncooked shellfish, fruit, or vegetable. Treatment include chronic hepatitis E, benefit from using ribavirin and antiviral drug. So guys, thank you so much for listening me. Hope you all like the video and don't forget to press the like button. Next video will be coming soon. If you have any query, any suggestion related to the video, please mention it in the comment section. Stay tuned and wait for update. Thank you so much. Bye bye. Take care.